Hello, in this video I'm going to show how to create multiple plumb views of this project in Grasshopper. So I'm going to show basically how to use this command directly in Grasshopper. We already have a building with the following levels, and I'm going to create a plumb view for each one of these levels. So let's launch Grasshopper, and I have already created a rectangle that will determine the boundary of the plumb views and an insert point for the position of the plumb views. So I'm going to reference that. A point param on one hand, I do right click to set that point, and a curve for the rectangle. I do right click, set one curve. So I have both objects referenced in Grasshopper. Now, I'm going to use a building param that I can find under architectural objects to reference also the building that I created in the document. So I do right click, set one building, and VisualArQ will show me this dialog with the list of buildings. Since I have just one, I need to select it. Now, if I deconstruct this building, and I can do it with a component that can be found under VisualArQ, levels, deconstruct building, I can get the information of the building elevation and the level that it contains. And with another component, deconstruct level, I can get the information of these levels, such as the names or the different elevations of each one. Now, I'm going to define a series of points where we'll determine the insert point of each one of the plumb views that I will generate. So I'm going to translate this point into this direction according to some dimension that can be the same as the size of the rectangle. So we'll use a component under surface, analyze surface dimensions to get the dimensions of this rectangle. And now I will use a move component from the transform Euclidean move and a vector in the x direction that I will use to specify the distance among each point. So if I just connect the u dimension and the point as the geometry to move, I will just get one point. So I need a series of values to generate as many points as plumb views I will need. So I will use a series component under sets, sequence, series to generate this list of vectors. So the first element will be 0, the step would be this dimension, and the count will be the number of levels. And I can measure that with the list length. So I go to sets, list length, and get the number of levels that I have in that building. I connect this to the count. I will move this a little bit further. And now I can connect this value to the x vector. If I want to add some separation among these points, I can just go to params, number slider, and under math, addition, add a value between this distance and this margin. Now, if we change the value of this separation, we can see how the points move. Now, we just need to define the plumb view component that we can find under VisualArQ, annotation, plumb view, which requires the insertion points that are those. The curve is the rectangle that we have referenced at the beginning. And the levels are those that I have obtained reconstructing the building. But if we take a look at the names of these levels, we can see that they are not ordered. I have the level minus 1, in a wrong order. So I will order these levels according to elevations that I can obtain from here. So I'll go to Sets, List, Sort List, and the keys would be the different elevation values, and the values would be the levels. What I've got here are the levels ordered by their elevation. So I just need to connect these to the levels. And finally, bake this component. I can close Grasshopper and see the different plumb views that I have generated automatically.